about ourselves.
Feeling better about ourselves.
You don't seem to be feeling better about yourself
I'm
today.
I'm tired today. I'm just really tired. I can't see very well right now. Just blah.
Blah, blah, blah,
it's like
blah,
this left eye feels like it's all like droopy. I look like I'm stone or something. I don't even know what that looks like, but don't I look...
I wouldn't know. I have no idea what being stoned is.
I know, but do I look...
You look a little tired. You look a little tired. But you're
everybody at work today asked me, what's wrong with you? Because I was quiet when I guess people aren't used to me being quiet.
No. I can always tell when you're mad because you're not quiet. I can always tell when you're mad because you're quiet.
Yes.
Because you're usually chatty Cathy.
No, I would agree with you. I would agree with you on that.
But today you're a little, but you're sucking it up. You're here for
I'm here for the people.
The people. Well, we decided a week ago that if you're new to this, if you're new to listening to us or watching us, we decided a week ago that we're going to try and feel better about ourselves, get in shape, maybe lose some weight, start exercising.
And supposedly someone lost 4 pounds.
I lost 4 pounds. I weighed 188.8 last week, and I weigh 184.8 this week. I lost 4 pounds. So, yeah.
I think he cheated.
No. And you're saying, well, how did you do it? I go, because I used to drink like 3 or 4 sodas a day.
Did you?
I cut down to 1. I'm drinking 1 soda a day. That's it. I'm done. I drink 1. That's it.
Very good.
I'm done. So that part I've done.
Okay.
And I think maybe just
I didn't lose anyway. I think I gained weight. I'm on the scale today. I'm not going to say it because I look like I gained like a couple pounds.
But it doesn't look like you gained weight.
Shut up.
But anyway.
But I haven't been doing my weight watchers point system, gosh, since like before Christmas. And I just can't get on board.
You just can't get back into the swing.
No, I just can't do it. I don't know why. I mean, obviously I want, okay, this is really irritating because I like totally cannot see out of the side of my face.
How's that better?
Yes.
But we're going to, like I said, I'm going to start walking our granddaughter. And maybe you can walk with us and when you're here.
Okay. I was going to say, you know what? Let me tell you how inspirational I was today. Let me tell you all. So on Mondays, I get up early. I work 7 to 3 and I do a lot of different things. It's a different job. I'm with different
company.
Company and different stuff. It's retail. Which I've always been ice skating business for 38 years. So this is retail now, which I really enjoy. I enjoy working with people. I really enjoy it all.
So 38 years you started, when did you start working in the ice skating business?
When I was 20.
20, so okay. So we got your age.
Yeah, well, maybe you should know. I don't hide my age.
I'm just kidding.
Anyway, I got something new, kind of like I do, kind of similar to what I used to before, a little bit more. And then you do like what we call callbacks and you just... It's a long, complicated story. I don't know how much you're allowed to say or not say. So I did a lot of walking today. And I was
going to... steps, don't you have your watch?
Yeah, I have my watch. I was going to tell you when I got home, oh, we should go for a walk because it's not a bad day today.
It's actually a nice day out.
So I stood for... I burned 503 calories today.
There you go.
I stood for 11 hours. I don't think that's accurate. And I walked 11,640 steps, which is 5.39 miles.
Well, there you go.
So that's what I did today.
So that's good. That's keeping you in shape, keeping you
right. But I was
keeping your body.
I had inspiration today to come home and say, "Let's go for a walk."
Which I would have said yes.
Yeah, I think you would have because you got to take a nap, which even though it was only 20 minutes.
I took a 20-minute cat nap because our daughter was sick. She brings our granddaughter over every day, and she was sick, so she picked her up early, which gave me a chance to go back to sleep. I slept for like 20 minutes. That's all I could do. That's it. I'm not complaining.
A 20-minute cat nap.
I got a power nap.
Sometimes those are better, they say.
They do, and I feel good now. I feel good. I don't feel tired, and I can see out of both eyes, and I feel good. But anyway, we did have some people join us.
Yes, we did. I was excited. So, I'm sorry I didn't respond to a lot of people. I'm just not really on this whole thing. I don't know
But why. I'll read what they said. Okay. J-O-J-O said, Jack, does Mentos make you gain weight? And if people don't know what Mentos is, in the Jane Jack world, it means something
stupid
else.
Stuff.
So it can be if you use it too much. Bill said, love the podcast. I'm looking forward to maintaining health at 56 and drop 10 pounds. I find a fitness tracker really helpful to keep track of 30-minute workout day. A 30-minute minimum daily workout. Keep it up, guys. So yeah, so that helps, too, if you have, I guess, you know, a tracker like you have.
Yeah, I have that. And I do watch it because when I used to this other job back during the holidays, I mean, I was doing like 18,000 steps a day, and I was losing weight because I was really active. So now I need to, you know.
But I also cut back. When we went to the grocery store, I didn't buy it.
Yeah, but you still look.
But I didn't. Okay. I didn't buy
it. I want to ask people out there. So we're like trying to eat better, and you didn't. No, you're right. You didn't buy anything.
I didn't buy donuts. I didn't buy cupcakes.
And I'm very proud of you. I know cookies. That was hard for you.
I ran by it.
You did. So but then you came upstairs with your bowl of pretzels.
Yeah, they're just pretzels, though.
I know, but they're still calories. So it's hard for me to sit there while you're eating away.
They're little stick pretzels. You're making them sound like they're big, greasy
pretzels. It doesn't matter. I don't have willpower. Okay. What? I sound so bad. I'm sorry, you guys, that irritating.
Well, you know what? Okay, I'll try not to bring the pretzels up. Let's go back to that.
But anyway, I don't know how he lost weight. I think he cheated. I think you took an enema before you went on the scale. That's how you cheat.
That's what I did. Gail says, I'm joining. I gained 10 pounds since retiring 3 months ago. Yeah, retiring can be.
Yes, I gained 25 pounds. Was it Carol?
Gail.
Oh, Gail. Sorry. Gail, I gained like, are you doing this right?
Yeah.
Okay. I gained, when I retired, semi-retired.
I'm going to do it wrong. I'm reading the names.
I'm just picking on you. I gained 25 pounds. That's why I started in August, the Weight Watchers, because I gained way more than I never even weighed that much when I
was pregnant.
When I was pregnant. Thank you. So, and then she talked about menopause. Oh, no, that's Laura. Go ahead. I'm going on.
Laura says, yeah, because I know when we lost our job, I put on more weight because I wasn't doing anything.
Right.
I mean, I was just sitting there sulking and eating. So.
Yes.
But let's see.
I wonder if you guys, do you find yourself, when I'm bored, I eat more. What about you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a struggle because I did buy some apples.
You did.
And you bought some fruit, so I'll eat that instead of like.
Like I had a banana because I was kind of hungry. So I'd grab like
four donuts. Then a half hour later, I'd eat a bunch of cookies. And then I was eating bad. So this week, right. I might probably lost 4 pounds because I didn't do any of that. So that I'm not cheating. Laura says, you two are fun to watch. I'll join in. Menopause screwed me over too, Cyndi.
I'm glad. Well, I'm sorry it happened, but I'm glad you're part of my team on this menopause. Stupid
the menopausal team.
Ridiculous.
I'm a slow runner and used to be fast. I want to lose some weight to gain the speed back and stay healthy as I age. And that is the hardest part.
I think that's the hardest part because I think I was just talking to somebody because we have some discounts going and one of the discounts is on my birthday. And I was all excited and I said, guys, this is going to be my last, when I turn, it'll be 59 on my birthday. And it'll be my last year of 50s. Wow. And I can still remember turning 50, which I swear it was just a year ago. I don't know what you're supposed to feel like at 59. Sometimes my body does tell me. Does your body tell you?
My body told me a long time ago.
I know that. So. Well, you have a lot of back problems.
You said, you need to stop.
But last night I woke up because my hips were killing me while I was sleeping.
Yeah, that's how I sleep.
Yeah.
Me every day.
I don't know how you do it.
I just deal with it. Usually I eat donuts to make myself feel better.
Great.
TC Mom 9699 says, I'd like to lose about 20 pounds I gained after I broke my knee.
Ooh, God, that must have been horrible.
We go to the gym pretty often, but my eating habits haven't been very good, and I know I need to change that.
Well, I hope you do that, and I'm sorry injuries, to hear about your knee.
Injuries are, and plus when you get older, too, injuries yes. are even worse. So
yes.
It's like, I know when I got really out of shape when I had shoulder surgery. Yeah. I stopped working out. I stopped doing a lot of things.
Yeah, and then I had to give you a kick in the butt to get you up and going.
Get it. I'm sick of this.
Because I just think sometimes.
You get mopey.
You get mopey, and sometimes you need someone to kind of kick you back, kick you a little bit and say, I didn't kick him physically.
Well, she hit me with a baseball bat.
Oh, my God.
That hurt. Up right inside the head.
No.
Oh!
Whatever.
It hurts right here. Not here or here, but right here.
Good talk. No. See, that's another thing about menopause. I forgot what I was going to say.
No, it's about being hurt.
No, I'm not talking.
Okay.
This is me not talking.
Yes. Sarah says, I'm so excited to see your healthy journey. I'm rooting for you both.
Thanks, Sarah.
I really had a tough year with my daughter being diagnosed with a chronic illness and my father passed away. So I've actually lost 10 pounds from stress.
Wow, that does do it.
Stress is bad.
Yeah, I remember we had some difficulty with one of our teenage daughters. You know, I pretty much lost my appetite, and it's just difficult.
I had the business. We had a business that wasn't successful, and customers kept coming up to me going, "Are you all right? Are you all right? Are you?"
And it wasn't until you saw that video of me, right?
This was on for like a month. I go, "Yeah, I'm fine. I'm fine. I'm fine." And then I saw a video of myself. We were shaking hands.
You used to coach hockey.
I used to coach hockey, and my team won the tournament. So I was all jazzed up. But then I saw, I go, holy crap, who's that guy? Oh, that was me.
Yeah, I know.
I lost like 40-something pounds.
Yeah, it was bad.
And I didn't know if it was denial or just...
Who knows?
Just more paint.
Because I know I told you. I said, you don't look good. You're like, I'm fine.
I'm fine. But everyone kept saying, are you okay? I hate to ask you this. Because people were, you know, just regular customers are like going, you know, so then you see yourself go, wow, okay. So,
right.
But stress is a bad thing. This year I'm getting back into lower stress level, gaining back the weight, muscle, not fat. I'm enjoying life more. I'll be 43 next month, and I don't want to feel 10 years older than I am. I just want to be, want more positive energy in my life. So thankfully, I have you two crazy kids to help me with that. Love
you. I think it's much harder. Maybe people will disagree with me, but this is my feeling. I think it's much harder to stay positive and have a positive attitude. I try to do that every day.
When you're older?
No, I think just in general.
In general?
I think it's hard. I think when you're in your 20s, it's easy to be positive. But I think the 20-year-olds now, it might be more difficult because they have so much more craziness, social media and so
much. Well, you know, you think back when I was 20, I wasted so much time complaining about stuff that I shouldn't have complained about.
Probably.
Whereas now you realize, oh, that was just a waste of energy. Whereas now...
Well, the one
thing I guess it's always a waste of energy.
Yeah, I can think it is. But I think the one thing that I do, if I have to say anything positive about getting older, is that I feel better of who I am as a woman. As you get older, I think you grow into yourself.
More and
you,
confidence.
You have more confidence. I don't want to say I don't care what people think. I care about what you think and what my kids think and my grandchildren. But I don't worry so much if someone doesn't like me, because I know I'm difficult and maybe someone doesn't like my personality. I come across strong. So I'm okay if you don't like me.
No.
I'm all right with that. I try to have a nice heart and care about people and be kind and treat people how I would want them to be treated. But it doesn't always work that way. I try to hold my personality in a little bit so people don't, like, because I am a little bit over the top. So I try to hold back a little bit so people don't get used to that personality once I'm comfortable.
You try to break them in.
I try to break them into my craziness. But not you.
You're not crazy.
I don't mean crazy. I'm just like, but I can be loud and kind of like, ooh, overwhelming.
Yeah.
And some people may not like that. That's okay. But I think as you get older, that's the coolest thing about getting older. Don't you agree? I think you feel a little bit better. The other downside is your body definitely tells you, hello, you're in your 50s.
Well, anything you injured, for you young people at home, anything you injured early in life will come back to haunt you. I'll get an ache and I'll go, oh, that's right, I broke my hand here. I broke my hand. That's right, I sprained my ankle 100 times. So anything that you start to ache, you go, what did I do? Oh, no, that's just life's...
Right.
If you live hard, and we were both athletes and both, you know,
we would run into things, just kind of dust it off and keep going.
Where now it's like I'm rolling on the ground. Oh, no, I'm dying.
You're not that bad.
Oh, I got a bump up. Help me.
You're not like that.
I fall and I can't get up.
I do call you Jackie Drama, though.
Because it does hurt.
It does.
Back then, it didn't hurt.
I think people that have been married for a while, you know, over 15 plus years, I think that's another thing you notice. Like, your husband, Jack never complained about his body. He always sucked it up, and now you complain more than you ever did.
Because it just...
Because I'm not used to hearing you complain. Because you're not a complainer.
Because it hurts more
now. Well, you're
a
complainer, but not about your...
I'm a complainer, but it hurts...
Not about your body.
It hurts more now than it used to.
Right.
So I think that's the problem.
Yeah.
You know, you just keep pushing through it, but it's just sometimes you can't sleep and it's
right.
But look, for you young kids watching this, you're going to remember 30 years from now, that old crackpot Jack guy said I was going to. He was right.
Yes.
Because it does, and you know, I remember people telling me you should let that heal. You know, and I go, I would just wrap it up, and now it's like, oh, I should have listened.
Yes.
I mean, it wasn't like I was getting paid.
$96
But I sprained my ankle playing softball. I'd go play hockey the next day because the boot of the skate would keep it secure, which I wouldn't feel the pain.
Right.
And now it's like, there's no way I can do it now.
No.
There's no way. But
no.
That's it. But that's what we've got so far this week.
We've had, like I said, I'm sorry. I was all gung-ho about it, and I've not had a good week to do it. But I mean, I haven't, like, gone crazy.
No.
I just need to start counting the number. I mean, I'm eating pretty well. I just don't think I'm paying attention to everything like I used to. Like, I really wanted to, which I didn't, because I knew we were going to talk today. So you guys kept me accountable. I can't say that word.
Accountable.
Anyway, I was going to stop because I had to go to some store because I didn't get something. And I was going to stop by Target and get my thing of licorice. But I didn't get it because I'm like,
well,
you got
it the other day. And I was like, what are you doing?
I know. Anyway. But I didn't do it today, and I'm proud of myself because I knew I was going to talk to you guys, and I didn't want to, like, tell a story and not tell the truth.
And it's not too late for people to join in. You can still join in, and the people that have put up there, if you have...
Let us know how you guys are doing, too.
Is it working, like, tips, like Bill gave some tips, and just different tips on how you know, you can keep in shape. So
true.
That's all we got for this week.
Yep, I don't have anything else. Except, I think he cheated. He took
I didn't cheat.
How did you lose 4 pounds in a week? No.
Running in place.
No.
That's all we got.